most important event was the revolution in the French cinema in the 50s, started by the Cahiers crowd, that what they wrote and then ultimately what they made had the most profound effect on the movies of any movement since the 50s.
Suddenly, I didn't only see sets and artificially created interiors. I saw real interiors, a real house, a real kitchen, and it was just so fresh.
The Nouvelle Vague was an awakening, I think, for everybody. It was an idea whose time had come, to put it very simply.
They were unlike any movies I'd ever seen before. Suddenly there were these guys making films with handheld cameras, and there was just a kind of freedom about it, and there was a flouting of rules.
J'ai toujours voulu savoir ce que c'était exactement que le cinéma.
The chef, he wants to know exactly what this movie is.
Oh. Well, a film is like a battleground.
C'est comme une bataille, un film.
Yes. Love.
L'amour.
Hate.
La haine.
Action.
L'action.
Violence.
La violence.
Death.
Et la mort.
In one word, emotions.
En un seul mot, c'est l'émotion.
215, take 4. Action.
Who's that? Jake? Jake? Hey! Come on, Jake.
Hi.
When I went to make my only real Hollywood film, which was The Chase, I inherited the mantle of orthodoxy, of that kind of, this is the way we do it.
Yes, that doesn't take much sense, I guess.
You'd come in the morning and rehearse a sequence and then turn it over to the cameraman, and then you could wait four or five hours while they lit and lit and lit. And it made no sense. It made no sense at that time. Because the film was so much faster, and it didn't require that old Hollywood thing, which was to make the old actresses look beautiful. Essentially, that was it. It was old actresses and old actors.
So the new wave came along.
The new wave came
along.
What did it say?
How did it change? How did it transform all of
it? It said, you know, it's immediate. It's a medium about now. You know, it's a real finger-popping medium, and it said, things can happen now.
All the filmmakers who were involved, cinematographers, directors, there was no accident. It was absolutely a very conscientious filmmaking with very little money, and sometimes all those obstacles are really can work on your side.
Simple. We didn't have a camera car. We had a Chevy convertible, and I had a zoom lens, and I was operating and focusing and zooming, and I was directing the director himself and Peter Fonda, Dennis Hopper. And that was, you know, whenever we came to a wonderful location or whatever, we thought, you know, this is this is a perfect background for a certain playfulness, and it's an improvisation. The visuals were born right there, immediately. And that's the immediacy which came from the French New Waves. That's how they all did. That's how, you know, you can smell that freshness coming at you from the screen.
In New York, fans of the French New Wave launch their own magazine. There are queues outside art house cinemas, and students study film for the first time.
The New Wave really gave me a feeling of freedom to go with my original instincts, so to speak, because the films that they liked and wrote about are films that I liked as a kid. Same pictures they liked. We were similar in age. They're a little older. But they grew up with the same pictures I grew up with. They were, as I say, a little older. And they liked those pictures. And they were American pictures. So I think you could say that they led me to understand those pictures that I had liked as a kid.
Take them to Missouri, Matt.
The New Wave write that in films like The Western, Red River, the director is more than a technician. He should be thought of as a writer, an author of cinema. For Americans, it is a revolutionary idea.
That was a good movie.
Yeah, seen here before once.
Bon, la notion d'auteur, c'est une notion qui facilitait les choses, c'est-à-dire que pour faire comprendre qu'on considérait ces cinéastes américains comme des auteurs et non pas des fabricants, des usiniers du cinéma, on avait lancé cette notion d'auteur qui s'est dégradée d'une façon, enfin qui s'est dégradée, qui est devenue maintenant assez ridicule, puisque les types ont l'impression qu'il faut qu'ils écrivent leur scénario, même s'ils ne savent pas écrire, pour être des auteurs, ce qui est aberrant. Il suffit de faire un film pour être l'auteur de son film, si on le fait soi-même et sans aucune autre considération que ce qu'on a envie de faire.
Oui, c'était essayer de transmettre un univers personnel.
Oui, absolument. Mais on peut prendre n'importe quoi, on peut prendre le scénario d'un autre, ou un bouquin, ou n'importe quoi. Il n'y a pas de film plus personnel de Truffaut que Jules et Jim, et c'est un film qui est entièrement pressé d'un livre, et qui l'avoue parfaitement. Et pourtant, c'est un film d'auteur.
Tu m'as dit je t'aime, je t'ai dit attends, j'allais dire prends-moi, tu m'as dit va-t'en.
In 1961, François Truffaut releases Jules et Jim. It enjoys great success in America. One young film student, Martin Scorsese, calls it the most liberating film in European cinema. Another, Philip Kaufman, says, it got me into making movies. The mood of sexuality without morality has stayed with me ever since.
C'était révéler un livre qui n'était pas connu et que je trouvais, moi, admirable par son écriture, par la simplicité, par l'innocence et en même temps la préciosité mêlée à l'extrême simplicité. Et puis, par la situation, montrer quelque chose qui n'avait jamais, à mon avis, été fait au cinéma. De quoi s'agissait-il? Il s'agit d'une femme qui, pendant à peu près toute la durée de sa vie, aime deux hommes aussi passionnément et tout le long de sa vie. Ils aiment physiquement tous les deux et souvent dans la cohabitation.
Qu'est-ce que vous pensez de notre ami Thomas? Pouvons-nous sortir avec lui?
Pas mal du tout. Une ombre de moustache peut-être.
Maintenant, l'épreuve de la rue.
All the time we were writing it, we were thinking of Truffaut, because we just idolized his films, and he was very influential. And both Jules and Jim, and later on Shoot the Pianist, had a lot to do with our mental set.
We really tried our best to write a kind of American Jules Jim.
Exactly. Yeah.
We were caught by the kind of that spirit.
Hey, what's your name anyhow?
Clyde Barron.
Hi, I'm Bonnie Parker. Pleased to meet you.
Slow down.
Take
it easy. Got my hand. Come on. Now, look here. I might as well tell you right off. I ain't much of a lover boy. That don't mean nothing personal about you. I mean, I never saw no percentage in it.
The thing that mattered in Bonnie and Clyde, although in some sense it's a genre film, the thing that mattered were, in fact, the thing that the New Wave stressed, which were the specifics about the people that made them unlike you thought genre people would be like, one, and two, the fact that it stressed those scenes that happened just before or just after the normal movie would have occurred.
And curiously, that's what offended people about Bonnie and Clyde. And I don't think we ever foresaw that, because the given for us writing that was how much we loved those characters. I mean, we really liked them. We would have liked to have had dinner with them. And
we would have killed us, but we'd have liked to have dinner.
And what offended the Hidebound critics, and there were a lot of them in the beginning, was that we obviously liked those people, and we made the audience like them, and we found them funny, and we lulled you into thinking these aren't stereotypes, but kind of complicated people with quirks. And then in the middle of those quirks would become something incredibly dramatic or even melodramatic. I mean, somebody's head would get blown apart. And people found the juxtaposition of those things difficult to deal with. And I think the New Wave is where a lot of that came from for us.
J'ai toujours été étonné qu'on laisse entrer les femmes dans l'église. Quelles conversations peuvent-elles avoir avec Dieu?
Vous êtes deux idiots.
Moi, je n'ai rien dit et je n'approuve pas forcément ce que dit Jules à 2h du matin.
Alors, protestez.
Je proteste.
The screenwriters of Bonnie and Clyde ask François Truffaut to direct their film. He agrees to discuss the script. He travels to New York. The French New Wave meets the American New Wave.
He sat down with us for a couple of days in New York.